Today, I want to show you two ways to make a seamless pattern in Photoshop. First, we'll see how you can auto-generate a seamless pattern from any image. Then we'll use Photoshop's pattern preview to build our own seamless pattern from scratch. Let's make a seamless pattern from this image. Like me, you probably have a lot of photos. You'd be surprised at the patterns that you can make out of the photos you already have. If your library panel is not displaying or it's not on the side menu here, come up to Window. And where it says libraries, click on that. Make sure that you're actually in one of your libraries so that you can see this plus button right here. You click on that and it says extract from image. And I'm gonna click there and our extract from image panel comes up. We have all these options up here. We can do shapes, color themes, and gradients, but we're going to do patterns. So you have a number of options for patterns. You see this triangle down here. You can move your image around so that you see that your pattern is changing. When you select these other icons, you can see that your pattern options change. I'm going to go with the first one. Here you can also scale. You can see that your image changes as far as the color spacing in there. And you can also rotate your pattern. Once you find something you like, now you just click Save to CC Libraries. And you can see over here on the right, it says Capture Pattern. This is the one that I just captured right now. And now you can close your window. And so now you can use your pattern you just created in a variety of different ways. You could use it as a background. I just cut out the subject here. And then double click on this pattern. And it brings it right into my document. And I'll put this below the subject. And you can make adjustments from here. You can make the pattern fit in any way you like. You can also double click on the properties of the pattern fill. Change the scale, make it smaller, change the angle, and something like that. Many uses for it. If you haven't subscribed yet, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications and you won't miss any of my tutorials. Besides making seamless patterns from an image, another interesting way to make seamless patterns is by designing your own pattern with any kind of shapes. You can use Photoshop's shapes panel, which is over here, which here you have all these shapes that you can use to make your seamless pattern. And you can even make a seamless pattern out of brushes. I have some images of a butterfly and some flowers, and I want to make something like a surface design. I already have my images cut out of a white background, but I'm going to show you the method I used to cut out one of these images. So we're going to use channels to cut out these flowers in the green leaves. I'll go over to my channels panel. I'm going to turn on each channel individually, and I'm going to see how much detail there is in the image when I do. So there's the blue, here's the green, and here's red. So I think I'm going to choose red. To me, it has the most information between the other two channels. And I know I'm going to have to modify this channel, so I'm going to make a copy of it. There's a copy. And since we're on a white background, I want to invert my red copy channel right here, Command I. And so the white areas are the areas that are actually going to be selected. And we're going to want to make those white areas even brighter. We're going to do a couple of things. First, we're going to come up to Edit, Fill, and we're going to fill the contents with white. And the mode here could be soft light or overlay. Overlay a little bit stronger. And the opacity of 100. So if it's too much or it gets too bright and everything's really distorted, you can come back here and redo this. Either drop the opacity or choose soft light. I'm going to say okay. So you see those white areas got brighter. We could add to that brightness a little bit more by using image adjustments and bringing in a levels adjustment. And you can use this to get those areas brighter. You see they're brightening as I'm moving the sliders just to get more of an area that we know is going to be selected. And we're going to say okay. When we copied this red channel, we created another alpha channel because we knew that we were going to have to modify that channel. So now I'm going to turn on all the channels and I'm going to come back to my layers panel. And now I want to load that selection. I want to load my channel as a selection. So if I come up to select, load selection, and where it says channel, it says red copy. It's already selected for me. And I say okay. And you see now I have a selection out of that channel. And now all I need to do is come down here to the layers panel and add a layer mask. And another little tip with our selection, if you hit Alt or Option and click on your layer mask, here's your layer mask. In the areas that are a little bit darker to help with your selection, you can lighten them up. If your brush is on overlay, you see there's an overlay mode at the top, and paint with a white brush, and you can paint on your image some of these dark areas. And since it's on overlay, it's not going to go outside of your selection. So you can go through your whole image here and refine this when you do this method. And when you're done, you just hit Alt or Option, click on your layer mask, and there's your image all cut out. So now with your image cut out, now's a good time to make any color adjustments. If you wanted to add, like for instance, a hue and saturation adjustment layer, if you wanted to bring the overall saturation up, or you can adjust any of the colors individually. I can use this hand right here and click on that. I can add more saturation to the green. Just make your adjustments to your image so that you can use it in your pattern. So now I'm going to create a new document so I can start designing my seamless pattern. So I'll come up to File, New. Now I want to make a document that's big enough in case I want to print it, so then I can crop it to different sizes without having to redo it every time I want a different size. I'm going to go for a 12 by 12 document, and I'm going to put that in inches and resolution 300. And you can make this document any size you want to. And now I'll just say create. And to help us to make our seamless patterns, if I come up here to view, there's something called pattern preview. So I'll click on that, and it says pattern preview works best with smart objects. Okay, we'll take care of that. Say okay. So right here in the middle, you see a square. So now's the time to get your images and drag them in the middle of this square. I'm gonna go over here where the butterfly is, and I'm gonna get that, and I'm gonna take it into the middle of the square. And as you can see, as I put that image in the middle of the square, it started repeating. So now I'm gonna make my butterfly layer a smart object. So I'll right click on that and say convert to smart object, because I know I'm going to be resizing it. Once I click on my butterfly layer and say command T, grab this handle, and I can resize my butterfly, and you see that it's resizing it all across my repeated pattern. And I'll click OK, make this a little bit bigger, and I can move my butterfly around. And as you can see, it repeats even across my boundaries of this pattern preview. And now I want to bring in some of my other objects, and I can bring this other flower in, drop it in my pattern preview. I'm going to make it a smart object. And if I hit Command T here again, I can resize and move my shapes. Say OK. Let's drag in my other shape. Make this a smart object also. I can say Command T and resize that. I can angle it, and everywhere else it angles and resizes at the same time. And if I want to add any more of these flowers, I can go to my Layers panel, and I'm going to say New Smart Object via Copy, and move that layer and say Command T to reposition it. And you can see that it automatically repeats everywhere else. And I can keep on adding more and saying Command T, repositioning them anywhere I like. And if I make this zoom out, you can see that I have my repeating pattern. Now obviously I didn't take time to really design this, but here I put this together quickly so that you can see that this is an easy way to make a pattern. And now if I want to add a background, I can turn all these off and drag a background in, and I can say Command T, make this background big enough so that it covers all the squares. I want to get out these lines. You see I have lines where I put in my background. So you use your clone stamp to sample all these areas and get rid of this line. Now you get rid of that line as best you can. Turn on all your images again. So now that I've made my repeating pattern, come up to View and uncheck Pattern View. I'm going to merge all my layers. Actually, I'm going to make a stamp visible layer. Shift, Option, Command, E. All my layers are merged to a layer on the top. And now I can come up to Edit and down to where it says Define Pattern. I'm going to name my pattern Butterfly and say OK. And now to use this repeating pattern, I'm going to create a new document, New, and I'm just going to create a square 1080 by 1080 document. Say OK. Come down here to the Layers panel and add a pattern adjustment layer. And now here is the pattern that I created. Select that. I can scale it down to get more of my patterns repeated and angle it, something like that. And say OK. And now I can use my pattern. And that's how you make a repeating pattern with shapes or images that you cut out from a background and make a seamless pattern out of it. If you want more tutorials just like this, click on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.